here are actually engaged in the mess, in the messiness of the subject of the play, the female genital mutilation issue. And I think one of the things we would be grateful for from the panel is a conceptualization of the tools or the concepts that will be useful to us at this point to deal with the mess we're in. Certainly identity politics is a very useful one. Subjectivity and objectivity, and whether we can be objective about a subjective practice, is at the heart of it. But maybe there is something else you can say to us that will help us grapple with this out of the academics and the universals into our particular situation.
If we're going to respond to the question that Rashida just asked, it's necessary that people understand that there is right now in the United States a prosecution going on which concerns a very long-standing cultural practice among particular Muslim denominations, of which the Dawoodi Bora, who are a Shia Muslim denomination, have been practicing for, it could be 1,000 years. And what they practice is a gender-inclusive variation on the Abrahamic circumcision tradition. They trace themselves back to Ishmael, who was the firstborn son, Hagar's son with Abraham, and they believe that circumcision is something that should be for females and males. And they have a procedure which is far less invasive than the typical male circumcision that is widely practiced and legal in the United States. But now their female part of it, which involves essentially a tiny nick or scraping of the foreskin of a female at age 7, is being prosecuted with very serious potential consequences. So, and if you describe it as genital mutilation, you're going to draw one conclusion. If you characterize it, as I just did, as a gender equitable variation on the Abrahamic circumcision tradition, you might be led to a different conclusion. And I think that's what your question was about.
Absolutely.
Panel here that is struggling with being in that messy area and thinking about representation of others, what kind of representation are we going to give or allow to be given to this long-standing custom, and who has the right to do it? Okay. So that's my understanding of the question.
One of the things that we all seem to be saying, and it seems self-evident, I would think, to us all and over time, is that the single best way to get past the issues of general group identity issues and understanding each other is conversation and actually making the effort to get to know people. The more people you get to know from any group or any belief system and so forth, the better you will understand it and so forth. And so theater starts conversation one way, science starts conversation another way. You're talking about how you envy the way theater has a certain power to engage us into the human story. I think what we miss sometimes is that we're showing one little moment, one little human story, but doesn't get at everything. We try to provide dramaturgical context for it, but even that is just a tiny, tiny fraction of what could possibly be understood. And so it does seem to me that in addition to us continuing to all try to spark conversation with what we're doing, that there may be more opportunity, going to Bobby's point, for how different fields, arts, science, and others, social services, and so forth, government, for God's sake, could work together instead of all in our silos to reach more people and have more impactful conversations. Because these conversations, frankly, even this is happening among a very self-selected group of culturally interested people, academics. Their papers get read by an elite set of academic elites. And most of these things, if they trickle out to the public, it's through a news story that usually has a perspective to begin with, and you get a 6-minute bite on a news story, and that's it. And if you're lucky, you've seen that.
You don't get justice, you get the law. Mm-hmm. Two different things.
Sure.
My mentor, Derek Bell, used to say all the time,
he's always amazed that the people who experience justice the least believe in it the most. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm kind of interested in the fact that why is this prosecution happening now? It's been going on for decades. This country is racist. It is sexist. It's a lot of IST things. So I think that is just as much of a question to be considered as, you know, what do you practically do? There are plenty of things that white people from other cultures come in here and do, and somehow there's no court case. I mean, I can't help but to think that also part of what's going on here is white supremacy, your essential values, and white people get to decide everything. I mean, we're having this conversation in English. Mm-hmm. That in and of itself, to me, says a lot.
Sure.
I truly think there is a mixture of racism and sexism with this.